Hi, this is Steve H, and welcome to Mac Pro Video in our new HD format. So if you don't see the whole screen, just stretch out your NED player and it will appear. So this month, we're going to take a look at the Signature Global tracks, and my friend Jonathan Pearl is doing a tutorial about click tracks. Hey, have you ever run into this situation? What I'm talking about is when you play a loop in the loop browser and then drag it into the arrange page and it plays in a different key. It's weird. And it can be kind of disconcerting unless you understand why it's happening. Notice that the loop browser has a play option. Play in this case, original key. But you can change that to any key or the song key. Now it's playing in the song key, see? They're both the same. If I go back to original key, it will play in the key that's listed with the loop. And not the song key. So one of the first things you have to do when composing in Logic is to pick a key for your song, and you can do that in the Signature Global track. This becomes of the utmost importance when you're using loops. So you open up the Signature Global track, and you can see that this song is in the key of C. So you have to ask yourself, what key is my song really in? So you just double-click, and it comes up with this key signature window. And let's say I wanted to be in E minor. And you'll notice when I click on the minor, it goes to the relative minor. So then you have to go back up and set it. Kind of weird. Okay, now my song key is in E minor. I picked the same key as the loop. Now I didn't have to do that. But I did it just to illustrate a point. Here's another loop playing in the original key. Now let's drag it into the song and see what it sounds like in the song. And I'll mute the other loop. Here's a good tip. Set your song key, if you're using a lot of loops, to the key that the main loop is in. That way, your loop will sound more natural. And once you've set your song key, then play back the loops in the song key. That way you can hear what they're going to sound like as they appear in your song. Because as you know, when you take loops further and further away from their original key, they're going to start sounding a little strange. They're going to start sounding like Igor loops. Next, we're going to take a look at time signatures.